There was lively debate on the special prosecutor legislation. The new legislation, which will allow for the appointment of a prosecutor to conduct investigations into alleged acts of corruption by public officers. The bill, noted Member of Parliament for Castries South, Ernest Lillet, begins the journey of restoring trust in public officials. Using himself as an example, Lillet expressed gladness that the bill would depoliticize public accountability.
Persons can seek to destroy your reputation, accusing you of all kinds of things, Mr. Speaker. And sometimes knowing, Mr. Speaker, that there's no basis for it, Mr. Speaker. So somebody thought I was rude to sue them because I'm a Shastri, and who are you to sue me? And then he asked the High Commissioner in London, see what you can find on Ernest Lillet. See what you can find. And he went through the documents in the High Commission and using the resources of the state, because I have to destroy Ernest Lillet, it's too rude to stand up to me. Too rude. Who is that little boy who feels he can stand up to me? You know who I am? And Mr. Speaker, they got a document that showed a vehicle I'd purchased had been registered in the High Commission name. The then High Commissioner did not ask the staff what happened. He didn't ask them whether they had paid for it. He wrote saying there's a missing state asset without doing any investigation.
Contrary to assertions from government MPs, opposition leader Alan Shastri clarified that the opposition was in support of the bill. However, there are what he called a few legitimate concerns about the Special Prosecution Office. One of this, he says, is the same level of authority being bestowed upon the Special Prosecutor as the Director of Public Prosecutions. He also took the opportunity during his contribution to clap back at the Castries South MP.
Abusing his or her real or supposed influence to obtain an undue advantage for himself or herself or for another person. That's just an example. So I asked a question. If you are a High Commissioner, and in the United Kingdom as a High Commissioner, you are entitled to purchase a car in the UK duty-free. And that duty-free, Mr. Speaker, is separate from the VAT. All persons exporting any purchases and diplomats are exempt from paying the VAT. But they are rules guided as to how many cars you can get duty-free in the UK. So the member from Castries South purchased a duty-free vehicle in his name as the High Commissioner. Made the application, the car was registered in his name, the car invoice, commercial invoice was in his name, the application for the duty-free was in his name, and the car was asked for permission to be exported in his name. But he gave that car to his brother.
MP for Souffre, Emma Hippolyte, stressed the need to foster a culture that counteracts corruption among public sector employees.
We need to create an anti-bribery culture. And that has to be clear and consistent. And that message must start from the top. That message must start from the top. And after we present that message, we then have to practice it. It is not enough for us to say it. We need to practice it.
Wow.
Because if within the Cabinet of Ministers we pass this legislation, we speak here today, and tomorrow we go back and do everything that is not in this, then we will not fight corruption.
Member for Choiseul, Bradley Felix, echoed the sentiments of the Souffre MP, calling for stronger work ethics among civil servants.
You can call it dishonesty where public officers steal the people who pay their money, the taxpayers, with their time, Mr. Speaker, with lousy service, Mr. Speaker. We have some public officers who believe they're king of their domain, Mr. Speaker, and it must never be that. We have to from the top, to stop some of the things that happen where people will tell you if you want a service, pass something on aside. That is corruption. These are the kind of things that we need to come and make sure we strengthen. And the problem is, from a political, you see, all of that thing stems from a political wave, you know, political, because if one government decides to take a certain action in a certain direction, then you get this, the other side making a political thing about it. And we just continue to be spinning top in mud.
Castries Central MP Richard Frederick hailed the introduction of the special prosecutor legislation as a start of a new dispensation.
The inculcation in the minds of those persons who intend on entering the political circles that this, their entry into politics, should never ever be contemplated, seen as a gateway for unjust enrichment. The Special Prosecutor's Bill, Mr. Speaker, will surely bring not necessarily an end, but will minimize, I am sure, the corrupt activity that prevails in this country.
Debate on the bill continues in the Senate on Thursday. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.